So good afternoon, everyone present here, especially the Honorable Jury and the Chairperson. Today, I, Aastha Mahana, is going to present an e-poster on the topic Hackers and Public Wi-Fi. So there is no doubt about it. It's tempting to use a public Wi-Fi. After all, it's free and it allows you to minimize data usage on your device and it can provide a faster connection. But while we all love public Wi-Fi, so do hackers, and that puts our sensitive information like bank details, credit card numbers, and more at risk. There are some ways by which hackers can expose your public Wi-Fi security or lack thereof. First is the man-in-the-middle attack. If you're using a public Wi-Fi, you are a potential target for a man-in-the-middle attack. This is where a hacker intercepts the data that is moving between two people or participants. This is especially worrying when you are sending private or financial information such as to your bank. You can protect yourself by making sure you aren't doing this like banking on public Wi-Fi without using hotspot shield. Additionally, you should make sure that you only visit secure sites. The other risk related to public Wi-Fi is the fake connections. This way, the hackers can access your information. Basically, they create a fake access point, and with this, they can access any device that connects to that Wi-Fi network. So when you are connecting to a public Wi-Fi, it's important that you confirm that you have the right network. Be super careful with this. Hackers will be clever and use network names like free Wi-Fi. Be sure to check that the network you're connecting is legit. The other risk related to public Wi-Fi is the packet sniffing. Though the name sounds silly, packet sniffing is not a silly practice. With this, the hackers get information right from the air and then analyze it at their own will. Basically, this means that when a device sends information across a network that is unencrypted, it can be read by anyone who has unknowingly downloaded some free software or malware, like from a spam email or unsecure site. What's even scarier about this is that it's not even illegal. The other risk related to public Wi-Fi is the session hijacking. You should also be aware of a hacker trying session hijacking. This is similar to packet sniffing, but the hack is done on-site instead of later. The hackers are after your login information, and they can get them by hijacking the session. Even if your connection is encrypted, it doesn't mean that the response is necessarily encrypted. The best thing you can do here is to use HTTPS sites and stop sending personal information on public Wi-Fi. Shoulder sniffing is another risk which is related to the public Wi-Fi. Shoulder surfing is simple. Basically, a hacker looks over your shoulder and watches you enter your PIN, password, or other information when logging into Wi-Fi or critical accounts. If there is someone near you when using your computer, mobile device, or even an ATM, they could be a hacker and watching or recording your actions. So remain vigilant and make sure that no one is peeking over your shoulder. Public Wi-Fi security is a big deal and the stats don't lie. It happens all the time. Even an inexperienced hacker can steal your information in a matter of minutes. So as mobile Wi-Fi becomes increasingly common, you can expect internet security issues and public Wi-Fi risks to grow over time. But this doesn't mean you have to stay away from your free Wi-Fi and ether yourself to a desk again. The vast majority of hackers are simply going after easy targets, and taking a few precautions should keep your information safe. The precautions which are related to using public Wi-Fi are as follows. Use a VPN, that is a virtual private network connection, is a must when connecting to your business through an unsecured connection like a Wi-Fi hotspot. Even if a hacker manages to position himself in the middle of your connection, the data here will be strongly encrypted. Since most hackers are after an easy target, they likely discard stolen information rather than put it through a lengthy decryption process. Other prevention is use SSL connections. You aren't likely to have a VPN available for general internet browsing, but you still can add a layer of encryption to your communication. Enable the always use HTTPS option on websites that you visit frequently or that require you to enter some kind of credential. Remember that hackers understand how people reuse passwords, so your username and password for some random forum may be the same as it is for your bank or corporate network, and sending these credentials in an encrypted manner could open the door to a smart hacker. Most websites that require an account or credential have the HTTPS option somewhere in their setting. So the other prevention that can be taken to avoid hacking is turn off sharing. When connecting to the internet at a public place, you are unlikely to want to share anything. You can turn off sharing from the system preferences or control panel depending on your operating system. Or let Windows turn it off for you by choosing the public option the first time you connect to a new unsecured network. Keep Wi-Fi off when you don't need it. Even if you haven't actively connected to a network, the Wi-Fi hardware in your computer is still transmitting data between any network within range. There are security measures in place to prevent this minor communication from compromising you, but not all wireless routers are the same, and hackers can be a pretty smart bunch. If you're just using your computer to work on a Word or Excel document, keep your Wi-Fi off. As a bonus, you'll also experience a much larger battery life. You should also stay protected from every individual who take all the possible public Wi-Fi security precautions are going to run across issues from time to time. It's just a fact of life in this interconnected age. That's why it's very important to keep a robust internet security solution installed and running on your machine. So there should be a system which should be installed, such as like we install antiviruses. Throughout any business traveler's life, there's going to come a time when an unsecured free public Wi-Fi hotspot is the only connection available, and your work simply has to get right then. Understanding public Wi-Fi risk will ensure your important business data doesn't become just another hacking statistic. Thank you. This was all from my side. Now I welcome the questions.